Okay, ranked alongside BMW and Mercedes-Benz and Mannesmann and all those other great German brand names, they come from Germany too. They are the Scorpions, current single to be number one. In the studio here on the Friday Rock Show, what we have is three members of the Scorpions. We have Rudolf, Matthias, and we have Klaus. Guten Tag, or should it be Guten Abend?
I thought.
Guten Abend.
Guten Abend.
Welcome. Schön, Guten Abend.
Yeah. Danke. Danke schön.
How are you doing?
Well, I'm doing very well. How are you doing? And what about the change of image then?
Very good.
Bit of a change of image.
Bit of a change of image. Matthias and me, we cut the hair, you know, but it was not that much hair anyway. And but we're still the same guys, you know.
Absolutely.
And ready to rock the world again.
Okay. Whose idea was the video? Poor Monica Lewinsky.
But it was an English guy, David Mellotz.
Oh, he's weird.
Yeah. But he did a very good, I think it was good that we used an English person because the English, they have a great humor. And in this video, it's very hard and very important that you're not hitting somebody too hard. In this case, I think the video, both Clinton and also Monica came over very sympathetic.
Yeah.
I mean, we cracked up laughing when we got the script from David Mellotz, you know, and A Day in the Life of a White House Cigar.
Yeah.
You know, and the song actually was written about, like, we wanted to try and write a song about the winner, and it turned out to be a song about the loser, somebody who wants to be number one, you know. And there's this one Monica line in the song where the backing vocal guy is making fun of the guy, saying he's got no job, got no blow, got no Monica to go, you know. And so, and David Mellotz, he put those two lines together, and all of a sudden we were in London in the studio, sitting in the Oval Office with 20 Monica Lewinsky duels dancing with flying V guitars around us.
That's a good idea. It's a fun idea as well.
It's the idea to do something humorous.
You haven't been to the UK to gig for quite some time, but so where have you been gigging? Have you been gigging?
Around the world.
Yeah, we've been touring.
We played here so many
everywhere.
Times in England that we said maybe give a little bit break. We're coming 100% on this tour. We will be here.
We start another world tour at the end of April. We start maybe here in the UK. You know, we go all over Germany, all over Europe, and onto the States in the summer, and you know. Hopefully
so it's back
everywhere.
On the road for you.
Back on the road. Yeah,
here in the United Kingdom, though, the gig will be when in the UK. It'll be what, end of April.
Must be the end of April. We're just setting it up at the moment. So sometime in the 20s.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Scorpions have been around a long time now.
Yeah, and still having fun.
And still having fun.
Yeah.
Still looking good.
Thank you very much.
Above all, still alive.
But you too.
You survived the rigors of rock and roll for a long, long time.
We still enjoy what we're doing, you know, and I think we've been in the studio now, recorded our new album, Eye to Eye, in 98, you know, for most of it, except a very few gigs, and so this year we're looking very much forward to go out on the road again, because it's still the best part to play live in front of an audience, and we still enjoy after all those years.
But what is the thing that you, other than the fact that you play together, and you're one hell of a cohesive and tight unit. Other than that, what is the thing about going on the road that you like? Other than the two-hour set that you do, what else do you like about going on the road?
We have many friends around the world. I mean, that's very good. Playing around the world, you know, you have your friends either in Asia or in Los Angeles or here in England. And that's a good thing about it. Also, when you're in a studio, it's always difficult working and working and working, you have no response. And when you go on stage, again, you see the people, how they're reflecting. I think that's this eye to eye. That is a very important point. That is communication directly.
There's a few places we haven't been, and it looks like we might go to Dublin, to Ireland this year, for the very first time. That's very exciting to see new places also.
Could be going to Dublin, but right now let's take this track, Rock You Like a Hurricane.
We did this one with David Mellotz here in London.
The video.
As well. In the 80s,
On the writing side, do you get any further arenas of inspiration, or do you go strictly for the rock bit, or do you ever look at a Picasso? Because I'm sure you own a few now, you know what I mean? I'm sure you've got a few stacked in the garage and go, I'm going to write a song about Picasso.
Yeah, why not? No, he was a great artist, no? Yeah, it's good. I mean, it's the inspiration coming on touring. Much on touring, the time tells you things changing, like Wind of Change was inspired by. The changes because of the falling of the wall, and also that we played in Russia.
That was such a smash around the world.
Yeah, it's amazing. This year it's the 10th anniversary of the coming down of the Berlin Wall, you know, and it's amazing. It's that long ago.
I remember it. I remember the Bryan Adams gig there by the wall as well.
Yeah, remember that?
Oh, there was a fantastic
show. Was it the Bryan? It was the Wall gig. Bryan Adams was in.
Bryan, didn't you open there?
Yes, the limousine. Big, like a huge highway, and we had this stretch limo, you know, escorted by Hell's Angels.
That's
we drove up there. there and opened the door, went out on stage, and we had 300,000 people sitting on no man's land, you know?
Yeah.
And it was amazing. And we had the opening song, and it was fantastic to be part of that show.
It was the atmosphere was like electric.
Yeah, Morrison was there
next to the Brandon Corner.
Yeah.
It was great, great people. Very, very good.
Okay, listen, we've got copies of the album to give away in these presentation boxes here.
Wow.
I got the cigars in here, any cigars?
Yeah.
Guess what? We've got this. No cigars, but never mind. I don't know how many of these we've got to give away, but whatever the number is that the generous record company are going to allow us to give away, we're going to require that people answer a question, right?
That's right.
So I want you guys to give our audience on VH1 a question, please.
What could it be? The question could be, what is the first single of the new album Eye to Eye from the Scorpions called?
Okay. You got the question there. What is the first single from the album Eye to Eye by the Scorpions? That's their album title. What's it called? Send your answers to The Friday Rock Show, VH1, 17 to 29, Hawley Crescent, London, and W18TT. Or you can get me on the email as well, tommy@segway.demon.co.uk. Okay? And, that camera there. Should I talk to that camera there? Hello, that camera there. I talked to the wrong camera, gentlemen. I think I'll leave. That's a terrible mistake to make. So it's back on the road, so it's more rock and roll, but in terms of rock and roll at home, who do you guys listen to? Absolutely
all
nobody.
Kinds of new music. Stuff, you know, from Smashing Pumpkins to, you know, a lot of stuff.
A whole variety.
Yeah, a whole variety. Yeah. I mean, we just come out of the studio and being focused on your own music, I personally don't listen too much other stuff.
Mm.
No, not running the risk of getting influenced by somebody else. But now, since we're finished with the album, we turn on the radio again, you know, when you're in the car, I like to listen to what's going on.
Mm.
And for at home, you know, I go out and buy special stuff at the moment. Yeah, I listened to The Offspring the other day, and I thought that is like a cool video, and it's a cool song, and you know, it's that fun moment.
Yeah,
it's it cheers you up. So
I like this new guy, Sean Mullins.
Yep,
this song Lullaby. Oh, it's fantastic. I heard it on the way we were mixing the album in Los Angeles, and on the way to the airport, I heard that song on the radio first time, and it's so LA, you know, and I like very much. I just bought it right here in London.
Good.
Very cool.
Thank you very much for helping our economy. Because, gentlemen, we need it. Believe you. Believe me, we absolutely
yes.
need it. Okay, well, I'd just like to thank you very much for coming in. I know it's been quite a short interview. I am hoping one day, if we're really lucky and we talk nicely to you and also to all the bosses at VH1, that you might actually come down into this studio and do a gig for us.
Yeah.
Because you've got a catalogue of songs that goes on.
We are famous we play everywhere where electricity is.
Okay. In the studio.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
And it's good to see you on tour in April here in the United Kingdom.
All righty.
Wind of change.
Great being here. Thank you.
What a smash.